Our Honorable Secretary. Press statement. Today, 11th February 2018, the 26th plenary of the All India Muslim Personal Law Board concluded in the historic city of Hyderabad at Salare Millat Auditorium in Kanchan Bagh. President of All India Muslim Personal Law Board, Hazrat Maulana Rabe Hasan Nadvi Sahib, presided over the meet, which was attended by 400 members, special invitees from different spheres of life, which included ulamas, intellectuals, social and political personalities from all over the country. The meet discussed and decided to protect the Islamic Sharia. It was decided, number one, Babri Masjid is an essential part of faith in Islam, and Muslims can never abdicate the masjid, nor they can exchange land for masjid or gift the masjid land. Babri Masjid is a masjid and it shall remain a masjid till eternity. By demolishing Babri Masjid, it never loses its identity as a masjid. And according to Sharia, it always remains a masjid. Without any doubt, we make it clear that the struggle of reconstruction of Babri Masjid continues, and that the appeal of the Supreme Court is being fought rigorously with all the resources available at the disposal of the board. The country's topmost lawyers are appearing for and on behalf of All India Muslim Personal Law Board and the Muslims, and we believe that the Almighty Allah will make us successful in Supreme Court, inshallah and ameen. The All India Muslim Personal Law Board fully supports and endorses the reform movement launched by the board, and it is also decided that the statewide committees and district level committees will be formed. These will be under the aegis of the central body. Next, the Talaq-e-Bidat bill moved by the central government is anti-women. It will create more difficulties for the women. It is against Sharia and it is against the Constitution of India. The efforts made by the board will continue to stop this bill in the Rajya Sabha. The board will start a countrywide awareness campaign against this bill and will also coordinate with the opposition parties which are opposing this bill. Countrywide women's empowerment meeting will be continuously held. Next, in the plenary, various committees' reports were discussed and the members present expressed their satisfaction on their working of the board. Next, after the last plenary session at Calcutta, many esteemed members of the board passed away. The president of the board offered his condolence and made dua maghfirat for the departed soul, which was joined by all the members present over there. On this occasion, the president of the board, in his presidential address, said, "The Islamic laws are based on Holy Quran and Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. The Muslims will not accept any amendment or any proposal for amendment in the Sharia laws. India is a secular democratic country which allows the Muslims and other communities to practice their religion according to their religious laws, custom and faith. In the present circumstances, the board will focus its energies on Islah-e-Ma'ashra, means social reform movement, for empowerment and implementation of the rights of Muslim women, to ensure that every reconciliatory step is to be taken to protect the sanctity of the marriage, to ensure that all steps are taken so that the rights of Muslim women divorcees are taken care by their families. Next, the board will take up campaigns to create awareness among the masses and in particular among the Muslims as how the present government under the garb of the Talaq bill wants to put restriction on the Muslims. On Babri Masjid case, the board is taking every legal step for the reconstruction of the masjid. To create awareness and understanding of the Sharia, the board will start a countrywide campaign for this purpose so that the Muslims are made to understand about the nikah, talaq, inheritance, and how everything should be done according to the Sharia laws. Lastly, the General Secretary of the Board, Maulana Hazrat Maulana Wali Rahmani Sahab, presented the General Secretary's report and gave a message that the real strength of the community lies in the unity. The real strength of the community lies in its unity. We have to save ourselves from disunity so that we remain as an honorable community of the country. The present environment in the country reminds us, this is very important, the present environment in the country reminds us that at all cost we must remain united, ignore our minor differences and adopt the path of moderation, and through our writings, words and deeds we must create a unity and peace in the country. The 26th plenary concluded with the dua of All India Muslim Personal Law Board President.